pretty much set now. They're off in the Woody Stevens, and a good start for the Californian. Let him shine on a far outside out for the lead. Zebros came out with speed two, and from the inside, it's Salute Dos Amigos, and Retrieve goes up in between horses now to be a part of the early pace as well. And then it's a length farther back to Clearly now. Merit Man is there to the outside. Another two lengths more to Tenango, who's got five to make up as the field moves for the turn. Then Honorable Dylan to the outside of Declan's Warrior, who has the rail. It's another four lengths more back to 40 Tails, and Capo Bastoni trails the field as they run by a quarter and 21 and 4/5 seconds and move for the far turn. And it's Let 'Em Shine on top by 3/4 of a length. Zebros running in second position. Toward the inside comes Salute Dos Amigos, who's right in behind the leaders, and Clearly now is there on the far outside. Break of another two back to Retrieve, and Tenango is down on the inside of 44 and 3/2 mile, and they're into the stretch, and Let 'Em Shine is holding on to the lead. Zebros on the outside draws up alongside these two into the final furlong. Zebros and Let 'Em Shine. Clearly now third, Tenango is fourth, and from far behind, 40 Tails has made progress and continues to gain in the center of the track. Declan's Warrior splits horses with a late burst of speed as well. They're coming to the line, and here's 40 Tails. 40 Tails got up, then Declan's Warrior, or Clearly now, followed by Let 'Em Shine.
Wild finish in the Woody Stevens and Todd Pletcher's 40 Tails with a beautifully timed ride by superstar jockey Joel Rosario.
Well, I think maybe as much as anything, this is great news for horses like Orb and Golden Soul. 40 Tails down the backside was next to last. The only horse he had beaten was his stablemate Capo Bastone. And Joel Rosario getting a feel for what it would be like to travel from way back in the pack. I mean, a big run, went wide. I think more than anything else, it tells us that the track is fair. They went very, very fast up front, and they paid the price. The front runners, both Zebros and the outside horse, Let 'Em Shine, who set a quick early pace, paid the price late in the race, and the horses that kind of laid back in wait came on and picked up the pieces.
There's a smile we saw from Todd Pletcher as just now the winner, 40 Tails, starting to pick up the pace. Rosario switching him to the outside, and in the instant, the acceleration is devastating as he runs down the front runners.
Well, yeah, you lose a little ground when you go around, and he didn't go around the entire turn, but he angled out in the stretch and avoided the kind of zigzagging antics of number 9 Clearly now, who probably cost the inside horse a little bit of momentum. So Joel certainly making the right decision, just angling through the middle of the track.
40 Tails gunning down Clearly now. Big run from Let 'Em Shine, simply tiring late. And Todd Pletcher cheering on Joel Rosario. He has one of the best riders in the business in the saddle. Like he knew he had it all the time, Jerry.
I think he did. You know, he's a pretty confident kid. He's probably more comfortable back there than he is anywhere on the track. I think he can always get up and make that run.
It's like a reoccurring theme on this show and the undercard of the Triple Crown races, Derby, Preakness. But I think it's important to point out the confidence for a jockey to win one of these bigger races before the main event, Jerry.
Well, it also, I mean, not only went just the fact of winning, but it also gives him the confidence that you can sit back there, relax on a horse, and make a run and get up if the pace is honest. Now, I think this was actually a little faster than honest, but I think that bodes well for him going on to the Belmont.
And what a big effort from Declan's Warrior, breaking from the inside, getting the photo for second. But the winner, 40 Tails, trained by Todd Pletcher, standing by with Jay Pridman.
And Todd, getting up that win, did you expect him to get up in time the way the race unfolded early?
Well, you know, I knew there was a lot of speed in this race, and the racetrack's been playing that way. I was just hoping they'd go fast enough. We couldn't change his style at this point. We're just going to let him run his race, and it's a tough little horse.
Now, you've got five going in the Belmont Stakes later on. You just referenced the track. Do you think the way the track is playing, is it going to be advantageous or disadvantageous to any of your runners?
I can't really say. You know, the one thing about today, there's no other two-turn races to compare it to, so maybe it'll be a little bit of a different dynamic. I think it's carrying speed well, but showed in this race that you can kind of win from anywhere.
All right, thanks, Todd. Best of luck to the Belmont.
Todd Pletcher, yeah, he'll be busy before the Belmont, saddling five in his 20-legged Belmont Army. For that jockey, Joel Rosario, he's on fire. That's his third victory this afternoon. A date with Orb in the 145th Belmont Stakes. Results in following the Woody Stevens, one of the most prestigious races for three-year-old sprinters in the country. The King's Bishop at Saratoga on the undercard of the Traverse Stakes, NBC will be there. Is this the kind of colt we could see in that kind of event?
Oh, I think there's about four or five in here you could probably see run back in here. Saratoga's typically a little speedier type of racetrack, so that would give those with faster horses a reason to come back.
All systems go. Joel Rosario and 40 Tales. Rosario, three wins on the afternoon.